Well, we're just more than a week out from next Thursday's highly anticipated NFL draft, but now is when things get really serious. So what does that mean for the Falcons, who have the fourth overall pick? First off, this week, they are going to be finalizing their board to the best of their abilities, and they'll be having some organizational meetings, one of which will likely include team owner Arthur Blank, and that's with head coach Arthur Smith and GM Terry Fontenot, letting him know the team's intentions the best they can. Now, the reason why I keep saying that is now is when the trade offers will start getting serious. Before, there have been some preliminary conversations about this or that, but now is when the compensation gets real. If a team wants to come up to that fourth overall pick, they're going to let the Falcons know what they are willing to offer. Then the Falcons have to decide if they're willing to move back. And everything that I keep hearing and talking with folks around the league is Atlanta does not want to move back too far because they're going to be counting on some rookies to play this season, whether that's the first round pick, we'll see. The reason why I say that is because, yes, Atlanta is in the quarterback market. They are doing homework on the quarterbacks. But let's look at a non-quarterback, and that is Florida tight end Kyle Pitts. Yes, he has been rumored to be a sweet target for the Falcons all along, and you can understand the reasons why. He's got the catching radius. He is a flexible option. He can line up in line. He can line up wide. What that would allow Matt Ryan to do, because he would be the quarterback then, is to audible. If a team lines up in base coverage because they see Kyle Pitts and Hayden Hurst both in at tight end, they can call a pass, audible it, catch it with Pitts' athleticism, and let him catch it and run it all day. Conversely, if he's lined up wide or whatever, if a team is in nickel or dime coverage, then they can call a run and they can hit a big yardage because Pitts is a willing blocker. Again, to go along with Hayden Hurst, as we know, is a very good blocker. Let's also look at this. Head coach Arthur Smith, last year when he was the offensive coordinator with the Tennessee Titans, ran 12 personnel, that's one running back and two tight ends, 33% of the time, second only to Philadelphia. And when they ran 12 personnel, they averaged 6.8 yards a carry. That was just a fraction less than the Kansas City Chiefs. When I say 6.8 yards, I mean per play. That was a fraction less than league-leading Kansas City. So 12 personnel, something Arthur Smith likes to do. Kyle Pitts fits the mold in so many different ways. So if the Falcons stay at four, he could very well be their most dangerous option and an immediate impact player.